You may have never seen a big bird like that, trust me. It's an ostrich, which is a very popular dish down here in South Africa and many other parts of the world. And here is Christine, the head chef of the Cutlof Spa, who's going to help me make, what is it?
Stew. African? Ostrich stew, yeah. Yes, even though it's a bird, people often think it's a white meat, but it's actually a red meat. And it's also very healthy for you because it's very lean and it's high in iron.
But it's also not gamey, which is interesting. It reminds me mostly, I could think like beef almost,
yes,
tastes the same,
yeah,
right? Like
a grass-fed beef. Exactly.
The dish we make, and how do you call it? Poiki in Afrikaans.
A poiki means a small pot,
in
really.
Pot, so.
Yeah. But if we talk about a poiki, we talk about the dish, the finished product of the dish.
You know, I've been here for a couple of days, and my ears, I pick up a lot of words, so I didn't realize how much German is integrated into your African dialects. It's interesting.
The Afrikaner came from a whole lot of cultures. It started way back in the 1600s,
yeah, the Dutch.
With the Dutch when they came to South Africa. Our language is very similar to the Dutch language, but we also have German settlers. We also have the French Huguenots that came to South Africa, and also the Malayan slaves that came to South Africa, and also, of course, the locals, the Zulus. From this area, and all those languages made up our language of today.
Right.
So we've got the ostrich already cubed. I just made it like nice chunks,
mm-hmm,
so that it can cook fairly quickly. On the fire,
mm-hmm,
we have the pot already hot. We're going to add the oil, small batches, and then just keep on stirring so that it browns all the way around nicely. It's not a lot of fat in the ostrich meat itself, so it looks like a lot of oil, but it will cook into the meat and absorb it. Okay, so next thing, we're going to do some onions and some garlic. So just it doesn't really matter how you chop it. Just
a rough chop
because you just need the flavor of the onion.
Gotcha.
Got it caramelized nicely.
And now comes the garlic and then the veg, right?
Yes. So Walter, we're going to add some water,
mm-hmm,
and then just let it gently simmer. I think the meat is ready.
Okay.
So next we can cook the potatoes.
All right, go ahead.
Walter, could you please pass me the portobello?
Absolutely, here you go.
Thank you. What happens with the poiki is now we have the water, we've got the meat, potatoes needs to cook for a long time. So now we can move the fire out a bit so that it's at the low temperature. And what's very important with the poiki is you make layers.
So later when you dish it out, you can actually see the different...
Yes, because if you stir now, then everything will fall apart.
Once you serve it, you can actually see the different ingredients in it.
And also it's often a cheap way to entertain a whole lot of people. Chicken will take 2-3 hours, but the ostrich will take a bit longer, so 5-6 hours.
So it's a very slow process.
Slow
so the
process.
Flavor system is fantastic.
So time for you to catch up with your family and your friends.